Hello. I'm very sick. I thought that I got sick from Shroud's party, but apparently a bunch of people in Austin got sick from a different party, which I didn't even go to that party. So I was like, what the heck? I think I got it from Simply and Russell.
Watching live streams.
But yeah. When I woke up today, I had literally no voice. I was like, I don't know if I'm going to be able to stream, but I mean, here I am. Here I am, I guess. But yeah, I don't know how long I'm going to be able to stream because I feel like I might die.
Sick sad.
Yeah, no mic gaming stream. Yippee. Yippee. But yeah, the weekend was pretty fun, I guess. It was fun. Mute stream. Yeah. Yo, Naxiv, thanks for the 35 months. Yoda, thanks for 29. Go to the doctor.
35 months.
I will tomorrow if I still feel like shit, which I probably will. Gangsta, thanks for the 5 gifted.
Yo.
Oh my god, so I went to LA. I went to Shroud's party. I made some new homies. Then we had the OTK Expo rehearsal, then the Expo, and then I went to Riot. Yo. Which was fun. Yeah, oh my god. Okay, so let me try to remember the whole weekend and all this stuff that happened. First of all, so literally everyone's flights out of Austin got delayed except for me and Mrs. But Asmin and Soda were the most fucked because they had to fly out at 7 a.m. because their nighttime flights got canceled. And I was like, oh god. But I was on a fucking scary Southwest flight. I don't have a problem with Southwest, I just feel like there's always strange characters on Southwest flights. But I was one of the last fucking people. So if you don't know, for Southwest, they don't assign your seat. You just board it. It's fucking Hunger Games. Everyone just picks whatever seat. And I was one of the last 5 people to board, so there was no seats left. And I walked all the way to the back, and there was a seat open between this man and this woman. And they had a backpack between them, and I was like, oh, can I sit there? So they moved the backpack and I sit there. And then about 20 minutes in, they're talking to each other over me and sharing snacks, and I'm sitting between them. And then I look at their hands, and I realize they're literally a married couple. And I was like, I'm just sitting between a married couple that wanted to hopefully get the row to themselves. So I asked them, I was like, oh, do you guys want to switch seats so you can be next to each other? And the husband was like, oh, no, I hate the middle seat. I'd much rather sit on the aisle seat. And the wife just didn't. Cheddar's crying. The wife just didn't say anything, so I just sat in between this married couple for the whole 3-hour flight, and I was just I just tried to sleep and read, but they were giving each other snacks, and I was just yeah, I mean, it's not that awkward or anything. Yeah, I was third wheeling on a Southwest Airlines flight. Sorry, my voice is so bad. At least I can't get anyone else sick. So, yeah, my voice is shot, but, it started yesterday. I almost didn't go to Riot at all, but, I ended up going, but it's getting worse. Can't tell the difference. What the heck? It does sound different. I don't always sound sick. And then, Shroud's party was the same night as when we all flew in. And first of all, so Nick, Finn, and everyone else who was on that flight, their flight got in the same time as me and Mrs. But so it was 9 p.m. and Nick was like, I'm not going, I'm going to bed. I was like, what the heck? So he didn't even go. But hold on, let me let Cheddar out. I think he just wants attention. I don't know. But it was a cool party. It was a Fallout themed party. When you went in, they gave everyone 3 bottle caps and a gold coin. And the bottle caps were supposed to be, you trade them for free drinks. But I was trading the bottle caps to the bartender. But I noticed at a certain point, she just stopped taking them. She was like, I don't want this shit. Everyone's just getting free drinks anyway. This is dumb. And so the gold coin was for, they had gambling tables. They had blackjack and poker. And you could trade the gold coins for 1,000 credits. It wasn't real money. No one was gambling real money. It's just like per 100 credits was like one raffle ticket. They were giving away stuff. So I had 1,000 credits and I was doing blackjack with Simply and they only gave him 500. I was like, wow, fucking sucks to suck. And he just never asked the lady to give him the rest. But yeah, it was fun. They had little hamburgers. And apparently Dead Mouse was DJing, but he wasn't actually there. He was like on a little laptop. But bro, people kept being like, what is this music? Like, this is weird. And then B-Dance, I think, was going on telling people like, oh, it's Dead Mouse. And they were like, oh. But he wasn't playing his own songs or anything. He was playing like remixes of like early 2000s songs. But yeah, it was cool. And so what else happened? I mean, it was kind of just like everyone talking, milling around. It wasn't like that crowded of a party because I guess Shroud like didn't want it that way. But yeah, it was fun. And so I'm not trying to like, okay, this is just like a thing that happens at a lot of parties I go to. And I think it's just because like Asian girls and emo girls, when they see another like Asian emo girl, they're like, oh my god, my people, like I have to collect this one too. So every like emo Asian girl was like coming up to me and being like, hi, nice to meet you. And we were like talking and stuff. And at one point I realized I was standing against the wall and there were like 5 Asian/emo girls standing around me. And I was like, oh, this is awesome. But I was about to talk about you, Russell.
Why are you gonna talk about me?
I was gonna talk about all the emo girls I met at Shroud's party.
Yeah.
Wait, can I say what you said?
I don't remember what I said. yeah, say it, I don't care.
Oh, okay. Russell was like, Emmy, can you help me talk to one of them? And I was like,
dude, Russell. I did not say that. No, I did not say that.
You said something like that.
No, see, but when you say like that, you
well,
make
he
me sound
was,
like
he
a
was
bitch.
Joking. No, he was, well, he was, I think you were like half joking.
Of course I was joking. What? Like,
yeah, of course. Well,
why would I need your help?
No,
to
well,
talk to
well
you
I, was, I was like, Russell, I think that most of them have boyfriends. And he was like, so?
I did not say that.
Yes,
I did not say that.
Yes,
she's lying. I did not say that.
Okay, haha. I'm lying. It's a joke.
I'm lying. Listen, I don't. Maybe I did say that, but like, yeah, I think I did say that.
Well, he was drunk.
Yeah, I was drunk.
We were horsing around.
I was drunk, so. And I was just joking.
It's just jokes.
Yeah,
all the
but like
girls.
I mean, maybe one of them wants like they see me and they're like, wait, I have to break up with my boyfriend for this guy. Like maybe they saw me in my fucking janitor outfit. They were like, "Wait, I need to bring out my boyfriend." Walked up to him, broke up with him.
Oh yeah, Russell was wearing a janitor outfit. It was sick.
No, it wasn't.
One of the only people that didn't like have any like themed outfit, but I didn't have anything to bring.
It made me feel so awkward. I like tried to avoid you so many times because I was like, "Fuck!" Like she's not themed.
That's just not true.
And Shroud was pissed about it too.
Yeah, Shroud looked so sick. He had like armor. He had like black stuff smeared under his eye. I
was
like,
he was,
dang.
He was pretty cool.
He went all out.
No, but like, listen, it wasn't like, I didn't say Emmy helped me talk. I remember going to you, I was like, Emmy, why are there so many attractive Asian women around you? I remember saying that, and I was like,
no, Wake didn't say what you said, but Wake was like, Emmy, it's been fascinating observing how you have the gravitational pull
of every Asian girl. Like, what is going
on?
Well,
I was saying, I think it's because when Asian girls see another Asian girl they don't know, they're like, oh, I feel like I also want to know who, you know? Like,
so you're saying that I should become Asian?
Yeah. And then they'll talk to you.
Hmm. I think I have an idea then.
What's your idea?
Cosplay.
I'll help you cosplay.
Turning Russell Asian.
Okay, that's not a good idea.
Yeah, you're right. That's actually not, that's not a good idea. You're right.
Yeah, well.
But like, maybe. I don't know. Okay.
Wait, are you sick too?
Yeah, just a little bit.
Oh, I'm pretty sick today, but
I
hope it's gone by.
Okay, no. So here's what happened. After. I was like, wait. I feel sick. And then I was like, and then the next day, I was like, I felt perfectly fine. Like, nothing was wrong with me. I was like, wait, was it that easy? Like, GG?
Mm-hmm.
And I went back to sleep. I woke up today, I was like, wait, I feel sick again.
Oh no.
Like, what's wrong
Yeah,
with
tomorrow,
you?
Or not tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Yesterday. Tomorrow, yesterday I woke up and I had no voice, and then I felt fine by the end of the day, but today I woke up and I had no voice again.
Yeah, I don't know, bro. It's like weird. It's like it comes and it goes and it comes.
Simply sick too. Jeff's sick. Emily's sick. I thought I got sick from Shroud's party, but apparently it's from that boat party y'all went to.
Yeah.
And
man.
I didn't even go to that. No, so y'all got me sick then.
No, there's no way. I feel like I haven't like been like close enough to you to be like.
Well, we were like basically like punching each other at Shroud's party.
Oh wait, yeah, I forgot.
Yeah.
Fuck, I actually did forget about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, I feel like I did walk up to you a few times, but that's because, like, you do just have that gravitational pull. Us Asian people just want to come to
us Asian people.
Just want to
yeah.
come to
Wait,
us I'm
Asian.
Actually...
Well, they weren't all Asian, just most of them were Asian, you
yeah,
know?
Yeah, there was, like,
But that's just LA, you know?
No, that's true.
It's all beautiful Asian women.
I mean, I'm, like, 0.1% Filipino.
Are you really?
Yeah? You didn't know this about me?
No, you've never
actually,
told me
Actually,
I'm
0.9.
0.9?
Yeah,
I'm also 1% Filipino, actually.
Wait, really?
Yeah, oh my god, twins!
Wait, so why are they all walking up to you and not me, then?
Well, because you're not a woman, I guess. Gotta get the sex change now.
Damn it! Dude, there's so much work you have to do. I'm so over it.
I know, I'm sorry, Russell.
Oh, I can't do this.
I'm sorry, Russell.
I have a question for you, though.
Hmm?
Actually, I'll ask you later.
Okay. Just ask me now.
No, it's just like, it's a question you won't be able to answer anyways.
What? What do you mean?
Because I saw that you went somewhere and I want to know, like.
Where did you see me go, Ryan?
I saw like, yeah.
Oh.
I was like, man, you must have some sauce.
I do have some sauce, but
dude.
They made me sign an NDA. They made
Wait,
all
really?
Sign NDAs. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's so cringe, dude. Like, why not just have the buddy system where it's like, I trust you.
Because that's why every fucking thing they ever made got leaked for 2 years.
Yeah, that makes sense, I guess. That's true. Alright, fine. I'll allow it. Alright, I'll come back to you on Asian. Alright?
Okay, Warren. Yeah, let me know when you're an Asian girl.
Alright.
Bye, Russell.
Bye.
Bye. NDAs are cringo. Yeah. Wait, so what was I saying? Oh, yeah, at the party I met a bunch of Asian women, and it was fun. And then there were these two emo girls, and they were like, you seem cool. Do you want to go to Chili's with us on Wednesday? And I was like, Chili's? Yeah. But we ended up not actually going to Chili's. I did hang out with them, though. And then the next day was, did anything else interesting happen at the party? I bowed and groveled and apologized to Shroud for, I don't even remember what, something about OTK. Because Shroud said that he's ready to start being our CEO again. And I don't know, I was like, I'm sorry my streams suck, and he was like, don't do that. But imagine, like, he comes to visit Texas, him and B-Nans, that would be awesome. Ugh. But yeah, it was I wish I took pictures. I'm so bad at taking pictures of any event I go to. I should have brought my Polaroid camera, dang it. I haven't been keeping up with that at all. Oh my god. But it was very, very cool. Shroud was not impressed with the expo. That's disappointing. But, what was I gonna say? Yeah, so then I slept. I know that's crazy. And then the next day was rehearsals, which means I went to the studio, I ate sandwiches, I sat on the couch, and then I went home. Yo, Mad Monk, what's up? Thanks for the 15 months.
Hey, guys.
I don't think I did anything interesting that day, literally. I think I just literally went home and... not went home. Went back to the hotel and slept. And then the next day was the expo. Which, you know, you wake up at 9 a.m. for that, you do it, you say three words, and I'm like, dang, I did my job. And then I went to go get sushi with the girls that invite me to Chili's and their friends. And that was fun. I actually did take a picture of that, but only because the waiter said that we would want to take pictures. Look at this. Hold on. We got a fucking boat! Come on. A boat! And they lit it on fire! I don't think I'd ever gotten a sushi boat before, but... yeah, they took me to, a very fancy restaurant instead of Chili's, and it was nice. Can't see shit on this flip phone. I was thinking about not using the fucking Android anymore and swapping back to the iPhone because I feel like people judge me for this shit too much, you know? Ugh. The flip phone, who cares? Ugh. I mean, it's also annoying. Because I can't use AirDrop, I can't use FaceTime, people make fun of my green text bubbles. I mean, who cares? Also, the camera's just fucking dog shit on Androids. I don't care. Ugh. You look like you're about to start a religion. What? Yukio, thanks for the 4 months. Thank you. Ugh. You look like you're about to perish, bro. I feel like I'm gonna die. Ugh. Oh, wait. I knew I was forgetting something. I forgot about the riot trip. I was like, is that really all that I did? Is did the expo and then went to not Chili's? Yeah, so riot tour was fun. Got to go around. Got to eat lunch there. And when I got there, I immediately called August, because I was trying to be like, yo, bitch, where are you at? And he didn't answer, and I was like, oh, he's probably in a meeting. And then we were just walking around on the campus, and then I hear, Emily! And I'm like, and it's fucking August, his fucking bald ass, and I was like, oh, shit, he was just out walking around. I just ran to him randomly, and there's like 1,000 people that work there. But yeah, that was nice. And I got to talk to a lot of people who work on those games, and it was fun. And they gave me tea and snacks. Wait, do
hope
I have
you
them?
Feel better soon and hope everyone.
Oh, they gave me a bag of goodies.
Day.
Let me go grab it. Hold on. Very awesome. Wow, 2x KO bag. That's crazy. I actually haven't even gone to look through this. Oh wait, this is my passport. They gave me stickers. Very cute. They gave me a Lux comic book, which I think I've already read. A long ass time ago. They gave me an hat. They gave me two lanyards. And a book. It's a notebook. Yippee. But oh my god, the Riot campus is so nice. Like, it's actually one of the most beautiful places ever. And they have free food, free coffee. Like, I was like, oh my god. Ugh. the glade. No, it actually is so nice. Like, you walk in, they have beautiful art and statues of all their stuff everywhere. It's clean. Like, everywhere's decorated after different places in their games. You go outside, they have, like, free food everywhere. A basketball court in, like, the middle. A huge-ass one. And people are just playing there. They have this place where people can, like, play instruments outside. They have, like, video game cabinets everywhere. It's like, oh my god. It's just a very beautiful place. Oh, can I say anything else about the Riot trip? We had meetings with a bunch of different teams, including the league team, and I was like, they specifically were like, we want to talk to Emmy and Chance, and I was like, two dog shit players, but I mean, it was a good meeting. What else can I mention about it? I mean, there's a lot of stuff I can't say, I guess. They told Shota this shit has to stop. Oh my god, okay, no, actually another thing is, me, so they didn't tell us to do this, we just got the terrible idea while they were there, and they're like, oh my god, we wanna wager on this. Me, Nick, Shota, Van, Lucari were like, what if we become, like, the worst flex queue team of all time? And they're like, oh, if you guys can hit diamond, we'll give you guys any skin you want. And Nick was like, any skin I want. And he wants the fucking $500 Ahri skin. And S-Fan was like, oh, I want Viridian Kale. And we were like, S-Fan, you can't play on our team. You're a bronze one trick. And he was really sad. I feel kind of bad. So maybe we'll let him on the team. I don't know. But, and, like, oh my, we made a group chat, and we were, like, plotting, and it was, like, so, like, I don't know what other word to use, but autistic. We're like, oh my god, we can make jerseys and film esports vlogs and take esports pictures. I was like, bro, it'd be so dumb. And, I mean, they're all addicted to League right now, except for Nick. And it actually works, too, because I play AD, Nick plays support. Lucari and Vay both prefer solo lanes, so they could do top mid. And Soda's a jungler, but everyone on our team has been diamond before except for Shota, and he's the most important role, and he's, like, silver. But I feel like it's funny then, because then we can all just, like, gang up on him, you know? Isn't he gold? I thought he was silver, but... Okay. I guess he did hit gold. Yeah. I mean, gold's fine. Gold's good, right? I think it's fine. Ugh. Shota is better than all of y'all. True. Oh my god, he is. Yo, North Dakota, thanks for the 30 months. Sandbag Master. Oh my god. Yeah, that would be fun. I don't know if it's gonna happen. Shota and Vay aren't even, like, available to play right now. So maybe by the time there's time, everyone realizes it's a bad idea. But, like, imagine the five of us flex queue to diamond. And, like, by the end, we all just hate each other. That sounds so awesome. It's okay. Thanks for 13 months. The comms would be insane. Dude, it would be so toxic. I don't even know who would be the most toxic, and that's the worst part, because we're all toxic. Well, Akari's not that toxic. I don't think Nick would get that toxic. I feel like Nick only gets toxic in games that he really knows what he's doing. Like, then he gets mad at people. Shota top it. Shota and Lucari top jungle. Dude, that would be like, imagine Shota ganking Lucari and just, like, fucking dying. And then Lucari, like, being like, you fucking Mara. Oh my god. Yeah, I don't know if, like, we'll even stick to it, but we'll at least play some games, I guess. Wait, but Flex Q, like, if you play with people, you all get placed into different ranks, right? Didn't they make it so that any rank can queue with each other for flex? I don't know. We'll figure it out. Because they used to have teams. Like, we could make a team. We were trying to think of a team name, too. And I wanted a team name that we can do one of those, like, abbreviations, like how CLG or TSM. And we only came up with LPD, LP Delivery, or TSS, Team Silver Smurfers. Or SSG, Silver Smurfers Gaming. But I think that there's already a team called SSG. CLMs, no. Hi, Cheddar. How about OTK? Fuck no. I mean, Nick was saying, like, oh my god, we can sponsor ourselves. We can put Starforge on our jerseys. And I was like, but everyone's gonna know that we're not actually getting paid. Oh wait, I forgot to say, like, how the Riot people were- Oh wait, I already said, actually, never mind. That they said that if we get Diamond, they'll give us any skins in the game that we want. And Nick said he wants the $500 Ahri skin to flex. I said I want that ugly-ass Jhin Chroma just because I know I'm never going to get it otherwise. And Soda said he wants every single Halloween skin, and they were like, okay. Blood is getting old, sorry. I just have, like, the worst brain fog ever since I'm sick. I'm sick.
Meow, meow,
I'm
meow,
like
meow,
sweating
meow.
Too. Oh god. Oh. Ugh. Ugh. Oh god. Okay. I'm gonna watch some vids, do the unban request, and then I'll see how I feel. I might skip gaming today and just go, like, die in my bed or something. You know what I'm saying?
Merp.
Merp. You're also repeating yourself, sorry. I'm dying. I hope I'm better by Saturday, because on Saturday we're doing a fucking game night thing with me, Ms. Seer, Emily. But I mean, even if I'm not, it's like, you know, you can still game even when you're dying. Like, who cares? It's fine.
Hello everyone, this is your daily dose of internet. This is why you never wake up a sleepwalker. This Jesus. Fake fall looked a little too realistic.
Oh, he scared the dog! He tried to save him. Stingray. Oh shit.
Please don't feed the demon river monsters.
What the fuck are those?
I just found out that if you bottle feed a kitten,
catfish?
You need to burp them just like a human baby.
What happens if you don't? They explode? Aw, cute.
They reserved the first two seats on this plane because they thought they would be the best seats.
And then look at this. So we are facing the cabin, basically.
What? That's so awkward. Aww. I wish Chompy and Cheddar got along like that. Why are you...
Package thieves are starting to get really bold now.
Oh, stupid.
He said, oh,
look at how she fills up these hungry birds as if they were jelly donuts.
Like, speaking of birds, the birds that were outside the door are all grown up now. They all left the nest, and they're all fucking huge. They've been flying around there screaming. They're all grown up.
So nosy. This path was flooded, so these firefighters help people get across.
Is that a wiener dog? Oh, yep.
I just want to let everyone know that I read your comments all the time, and I love the positivity in the comment section. I'm glad everyone enjoys the videos that I put together. So, yeah, bye now.
What a nice daily dose. I saw that there's a new Michael Reeves video I also wanted to watch. Where is it? I built a car out of scooters. Sorry. Oh, God.
A couple weeks.
Oh, God. Thanks. Thank you.
A couple weeks ago, I was in the ER. Not for me, I'm fine, but for my friend Tommy, whose wrist decided to explode after he fell off an electric scooter. It was pretty disgusting. It looked like he took the Photoshop drag tool and just went to his hand. And the doctor was telling us, as he was putting Tommy's bones back together, how common it was to get electric scooter injuries in the ER. It's up there with like car crashes and motorcycle accidents. And it makes you think, like, how can we make electric scooters easier to use and safer for people like 26. Tommy? And we probably come to the same conclusion.
Nathan Guy, thanks for 26 months.
Make a car out of electric
scooters. Of course, just come. Combine them. Yeah, that makes sense.
Now, when I say build a car out of electric scooters, I mean it metaphorically.
Thanks for 14 months.
But I also mean it literally. I want to make a car out of electric scooters, where instead of these caveman fucking tires, we slot in scooters, and then I weld together a frame in between them to be like the body of a car. This invention takes all the risk out of riding these dangerous, demonic scooters. No longer do you need the requisite skill to stay
upright. Are you gonna fall off and break your wrist?
A talent few in our society possess, if any at all. Instead, just sit down, hit the accelerator, and go. No balance required. But Michael, I hear you ask, how are you gonna hit the throttles on each of the bird scooters to make it all go? I am fucking getting to that. If you would...
Wait, how did he get four bird scooters? Second. Did he just rent them and just like...
Where the whole explanation happens. Like... It'll be cut to very fast pace.
Or did he
music.
Buy
subway
them?
Servers. We got subway servers.
Yoink. Nice.
The way you accelerate on these scooters is by pressing this little throttle tab with your thumb. I don't want to use my fucking thumb, because I can't, on four scooters simultaneously. So here's what I came up with. It's a 3D-printed thumb attached to a motor so it can actuate the throttle on the scooter.
3D-printed
cool, right?
Thumb.
Wrong. It sucks ass. Am I going to sit there diddling wires together like a fucking Cro-Magnon caveman? No. We're going to make it wireless for a couple of reasons, but mostly because I'm neurotic. So it's going to be 10 times more complicated for very little benefit. We can turn this old remote into a controller for the thumb thing. And now
what
it's
is
a
on
detonator.
His mouse?
This detonator can talk to an Arduino. We know, so it's all good. Then we'll take some microwave-safe Tupperware and put the electronics in it. That's not making it past TSA. These are all really basic components you can buy online. They come from a beautiful little place in China called... And just like that, we control the throttle.
Ew, what the?
Now you might be wondering why the scooter isn't plowing through my bathroom. And that's because it's got a built-in safety feature that makes you kick off and get a little bit of speed before the scooter accelerates, which might then make you think that's gonna be a problem for scooter car, and you'd be right. But that's foreshadowing for later. For now, I need to try to ride this. Not because I need to test it, but because it seems fun. And so I went into shit-covered Los Angeles to try it out with my friends.
Wow, LA is so beautiful. Going to an airport with this, right?
This doesn't look sus to you. It's my remote control car, dude.
Get on. The scooter?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Oh, shit.
Go.
That seems way more safe already.
It's great to see that work, but if I were you, I'd be thinking, hey, Michael, dumbass, why don't you just wire into the scooter directly and skip the whole motorized thumb thing? Well, there's actually a really good reason they're not my scooters. They're public rental scooters that you can rent on your phone. So if I were to wire directly into one, that would be destruction of property and make it illegal. But since we're just renting them off the street and strapping a bunch of electronics to them, that makes it... less illegal. All right, now we got four of these little fuckers, and I'm gonna cut out the 13 hours of soldering between that last clip and this one. I also noticed a problem with this controller. It sends the same signal to each of the little throttle things, so they all do the same shit, but we wanna be able to talk to each one individually. And for that, we're gonna need a more advanced controller.
Happy birthday.
So I got this Wiimote steering wheel off of
eBay. Oh my god, thanks,
now,
it is my
good
birthday.
I'm not good at electronics to make a Wiimote talk directly to these thumb things.
I'm
but
lying.
If we slip some software, some coding in between the two, I'm pretty sure I can make it work. Now, some people would call that compensating for my crippling lack of electronics engineering skills using computer programming. And I would also call it that. That's exactly what I'm doing. Hey, kid, you want to learn some Python? First thing, you're going to want to see if you can even fucking communicate with these things. So open up your little code editor, and we'll write some code to test it out. This line says connect to an Arduino over USB. That's our little transmitter here. And these guys are just variables. They're numbers. They say how much and which motors to move. These lines down here tell our transmitter to send those variables over to the thumb thing. And if we run it, it should...
Yes, I understand.
Nice. Put a cute little function up there. We'll save every scooter address in an array. And now if we loop through that array... And okay, and now if we loop,
what the fuck, man?
Just run the fucking, bro! I hate you, I hate you, I hate you. I hate you forever. Yeah! All right, so the next thing I should do is kill myself. Connect to the Wiimote steering wheel. We kind of just capture the steering wheel's position and use it to draw this red ball. But it gets a little cooler when you combine it with the code we wrote earlier. Now, depending on which way I turn the steering wheel, the throttle lays off on that side of the car. And with only one side of the car powered, scooter car will turn in that direction. I hope.
He even made a little game!
No, I haven't tested it. Well, you should probably go test it then, huh? Stupid. So it's time to go kidnap some scooters. Initially, I was worried how I would get these back to my house. But then I remembered I own a white truck with a light on top of it, which essentially makes me God
on the streets. Actually just yoinked
them. That sort of, we just need a quick montage to hook these guys up. Should be good to go. Problem, the front wheel can still turn, which is definitely a fucking problem that we have. We need a system to immobilize the front steering column entirely. So here's what I designed in Fusion 360. And here's what I actually made. I call it two clamps from Home Depot I welded together in my garage. Okay, all the controls are running, I got the software running, and I just activated all the scooters on the app. The controls look good. I'm gonna bank a right turn out of the driveway and we'll test it out on the street. A little push. I'll be honest with you. I meant to crash it into my truck as a goofy, haha kind of meme. Classic comedy. But I also 100% in my heart of hearts believe that when I turn the steering wheel, it would turn. I believe so much. And nothing happened when I turned the steering wheel. So I went in and did a Boeing 737 crash site analysis.
Oh my God.
I rebuilt the frame out of stronger wood so I could test why it didn't work. And I discovered some very disturbing things. Namely, it was that I didn't understand the concept of like steering in general. You cannot just power one side of a vehicle and expect it to turn. You are now watching a live video of me encountering this concept for the very first time. And like a child who cannot grasp reality, I keep trying to make it work. Cars don't do that ever. I do not know where I got these ideas. My only hope is that I'm becoming schizophrenic and a voice told them to me in the night.
He's just waiting.
But I can't give up. Tommy's out there somewhere with a broken hand. What if he tries to ride another scooter? He's so bad at riding scooters. I need to do this for people like Tommy, who is, again, so utterly dog shit at riding scooters. We need to pivot, literally pivot the front half of scooter car to change the direction of our rotational velocity. Am I using that word right? Here's a chart, you figure it out. We need to ditch the wood and go with a metal frame with a heavy duty rotating hinge. Like this one? Exactly like that one. It will take days, maybe weeks to weld. Oh no, there it is. Yeah, no, I cut all that shit out. It's boring, but if you wanted to watch it here. See, everyone's happy.
Wow.
Except for me.
I learned so much.
Again, haven't tested it yet.
Well, you should probably go fucking
tested it then. Yeah, no, I know. Thank you. It's just, I'm kind of worried. That epilepsy montage was maybe like 80 hours of work. It shouldn't have taken that long. It's because I learned to weld on YouTube. And also this fucking part, it holds the bearings that lets the whole thing rotate. I had to make it on a lathe, which meant I had to learn how to use a lathe, which meant I had to buy a lathe on Facebook Marketplace. And I also bought this couch on Facebook Marketplace. This is not an ad. I just buy a lot of stuff from there. What I'm hoping is we can use the same concept as before, where we use the scooter speed to steer the car. But this time we have a nice pivot to work around. And also it's only two scooters turning, so it's like a line instead of a square. So that should work.
I like how it just keeps looking more and more dangerous.
I think I smudged it. Fuck. Just get that out.
Astronaut, thanks for the 8 months.
This is so beautiful.
Yo.
I'm looking for a parking lot big enough to test this in. Last time I tried it in my driveway. I got a couple places in mind, like the roof of a Westfield mall. Just gonna move these. I got kicked out. Pretty much immediately. New spot, found it. We're trying to figure out how to take a piss. Not how to take a piss, like a place to pee. I'm in the back parking lot of trying to hide from their security. I'm hiding everything behind my truck, but I don't know how long that's gonna last. I think I just have to test it out. This one's not unlocking, and I don't know why. This can't be real. One of them is not unlocking. Why is it just this one? I literally tested it. Please. Oh
nice.
My God, it fucking worked.
The
that's
stealth.
That's creepy.
Oh. Yeah!
Oh shit. It actually steers.
Let's go again.
Yes. 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 Now, right?
Yes. His clamp fell off. Yes.
I think the reason we had that little issue was because Scooter Car got outside of the range of the transmitter, which won't be a problem when I actually ride it because I'll be on it. So that's good. Now we're going to go right.
Hi.
Okay.
Hello.
Now back left.
Oh my God. Do you see this?
Oh shit. Oh shit. 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 Yeah, yeah. Right. Brakes. Shit, honestly, I'm gonna add more than
9 weeks.
Welcome to the feature.
Holy shit.
Come here, let me show you.
He's got a fucking DX racer in there.
Yeah, we got brakes. So the scooters actually already have brakes on them. They knew that.
Stupid.
So I just took a $9 air piston and 3D printed a bunch of bullshit onto it. And now you can control the brake with compressed air. Don't worry, I've already tested it out. It's pretty good.
Yeah, I could have spent time with my family, but instead I spent days making brakes for a scooter car.
You're wasting your life away, you idiot! You fucking moron! check this out. We got a custom push-off system. Look at this.
You might be wondering why we need a push-off system. Well, you obviously don't fucking listen.
Things you kick off and get a little bit of speed before the scooter accelerates.
So we'll use a big metal piston to give us a push.
Uh-oh.
Not enough friction. I wish we had something made out of rubber.
Take off your
Trace
shoe.
Your foot.
Put your foot out of a sheet of metal.
Breathe a bunch of poison gas.
Nice job.
Now if you have trouble with friction, just take off your air forces, put the metal plate in, screw it to the piston, and wow, look at all that friction.
Wow. Wow.
Nice job.
Holy Hello? Fuck.
That was Elon. Blow up his house. Custom bodywork, a spoiler, hop a custom synthetic leather seat. Oh, we need a chair.
Come on, come on.
Lily, no!
So big. Should I like cut the seat? I think about all the dangerous things on this thing, and then I realize I'm in too deep. Like, I can't stop.
Shut up, dumbass. No one cares.
It's got everything. Too late.
Only one thing left to do is to make Tommy's wish come true. I mean, not now. Like, probably tomorrow morning. It's tomorrow morning, and the plan is simple. We drive Scooter Car across Los Angeles directly to Tommy's house. This won't be easy, but it's just the right thing to
He's
do.
He's gonna go into traffic?
With a broken hand. That's good enough
oh,
for me.
No.
He believes this idiot broke his hand on a scooter. No, I don't give a shit about his arm. It's like charity work, you know? Think of all the attention I'm gonna get for helping his ass. Are you still recording? I'm coming, Tommy.
Oh, man.
Can you guys help me get it over the lip?
Okay. He can't get out of the garage. How is he gonna drive around the street? Hey!
Fucking works! It like turns and shit. Dude, it fucking turns! It works like for real!
Progress is good, but we're approaching the first major obstacle.
Big road.
4 lanes of traffic and no stoplight. In Scooter Car, even the modest Prius will headshot you like child versus minivan. But no matter, I've already lost all regard for human life and safety.
He's crazy.
He's like a fucking
tramp. I can do the turn. How you going? It's hot out, no? Fuck. One of the scooters is giving out.
Oh no, it's probably the low battery one I started with, so I could create conflict because this is a YouTube video.
But that's no problem with Scooter Car.
Grab a scooter from wherever,
and you can simply replace. Let me show you how.
You can Disengage swap the scooters.
Locate a high lift jack. Jack it up a few inches, unplug and remove your electronics.
Don't use that.
Can't buy another one of those. Unscrew and remove your braking system.
Remove the throttle motor servo.
Undo the rear clamp.
Undo the front clamp. Remove the low battery scooter.
So this seems very, very easy.
Insert the fresh scooter
into your scooter slot.
Up your attached electronics.
It's the wrong way. Don't forget to
plug it back in.
So you
Return your brakes so you can stop at stoplights.
And just like that, you're ready to rock.
This fucking sucks.
Could I get one number four, the meal?
Really? Burger King?
From here on out, it's smooth sailing. Except for the street,
I
which is
blind
in both directions,
King.
But zero visibility.
Wait, it's fucking remote control.
Of all the places, why Burger King?
Forgot his remote control. He just do whatevers, you know?
And after a long journey, we were finally about to reach. Tommy! Tommy!
What?
I got your car.
You have my what?
Where's your fucking cast? Where's your
it's
cat?
Gone now. It's been months.
The whole video hinges on your arm being broken. The video doesn't make sense now. You understand? Sorry. You understand how the video doesn't make sense now? Sorry. Do you get it? Come on, let's get a cast.
Okay. What is
Come
this?
On. It's your car. So you don't fall on a scooter and break your hand ever again.
This thing looks
Shut
more
the
dangerous.
Fuck up. None of this makes sense without a cast. You sit inside of it. You sit. You sit inside.
Yeah. He's gonna break his hand again.
Yeah. You're not driving.
I don't know.
See you later, dumbass. Just sit on my lap.
Okay.
Oh, how sweet.
Don't worry, baby. Feel a little speed. Feel like you get a little speed. Oh, wow. Acceleration go crazy. I can't see too good, so if you could point out, like, what's going on.
So how come you have a helmet, but I don't?
It's fucking dangerous.
I think it's just a right helmet.
Oh, shit.
Santa Monica. Holy shit.
I know. This is not part of the plan. Oh, boy. Ignore it. Ignore that. Ignore it.
There's shit dangling.
Ignore it. Ignore
front.
It. Stop. Get off! Get off! This arm? Oh.
Ow! What the fuck, man?
Bro, your arm has to be broken to put it in here, which kind of does make sense when you think about it. It makes sense. The video makes sense. Speaking of your car, it feels better, huh?
Yeah.
Hey, man, you're welcome, and there's no need to thank me, actually, for real. You enjoy this, okay? Have fun, all right?
Enjoy this.
I don't think he likes it.
Wait.
Fucking dumbass.
Oh. Kill him.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it,
that
share
was
it
so
in your
good.
Chat and favorite Discord dooning server. 5 a.m. I don't even know where I am anymore. If you want to see Scooter Car in person, I'm actually taking it to Open Sauce. It's a convention that my ex-roommate puts on every year. It's like an adult science fair. It's not porn. I feel like every time you say adult, you have to preface that with it's... It's not porn. It's essentially hundreds of booths that the biggest nerds on planet Earth showcase their stuff in. I think my favorite from last year was
That's
a shrimp
awesome.
That fried rice. But yeah, it's cool. It's in San Francisco, and it's going on June 14th to 16th. And if you go to see Scooter Car, you can sit in it, and you can mess with the buttons. I haven't asked Will about this, but because I'm saying it, he'll be forced to let you do that. Yeah, maybe I'll see you there. And what else? Oh, sorry the video took so long. I promise the next one will be faster, more lies. And
You wish you were as cool as Michael Reeves. Obviously,
broke it on an electric toy moped that I built, and he broke it because it didn't have any brakes on it, and that's why we're.
Wait, he broke his hand all along.
And that's it. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Oh my God.
Time to talk about today's sponsor, Odoo. Why go to many places for website building when you
he
can
did
get
the
it
sponsor
Odoo.
Wall
Odoo
on
didn't
the
like
thing.
That version for some reason. Let's do another one. Odoo's trying to be like a one-stop shop for all the annoying parts of managing your business. They have an app for accounting. They have an app for e-commerce. They have an app for website building. Could you imagine how boring it would be to make all of those things yourself? I mean, the website's kind of cool. Say I wanted to make like an open source blog about like turning scooters into a car. You start with a few prompts about what you want to build. Then you choose a color palette, pick out what you need the site to do and what pages go in there. And you get to choose between like three different versions of the site. They say they use AI to generate the site. I'm assuming that means choosing the stock photos and page layout that best fits your business, which gives you a really good starting out point. Then you're able to go in and make it look exactly how you want it to look. Just edit this, put that in there, slap this guy. You know, why not? Here's all the source code
wow,
for the entire
beautiful website.
Scooter Car GUI. I threw this site together just to do the sponsorship, but like immediately the site was active. I didn't have to do anything. I just put in the prompts and like there it was, which was really cool. And somehow it's free because your first app on Odoo is free for life with unlimited hosting and support.
No
you get the free personalized domain name for an entire year. So if that sounds useful,
yo,
Smitty,
thanks for 30 months.
Get started with Odoo for free.
You only
today
get viewers because you look cute. Do you really think I'm cute? Oh, stop it, you. Oh, God, that was gross. Sorry. I need to go sleep.
You big little
thank you. Really good.
No longer cute. Yeah, I'm just coughing all this stuff out of my throat. I want to watch another one. Fuck, I wish he posted more, but I mean, I get why he doesn't, because these videos take so much work.
Yo.
I haven't seen the surgery robot video. To a year. Yeah, but they are so good. I hope his sponsors pay him a fuck ton. I mean, he's getting like millions of views, so he definitely makes good money, but...
Da Vinci
as
surgical
fan
system
vlog
is
what,
the most advanced
vlog?
Streamlined
oh, yeah, he recorded
experience
a bunch of
for minimally
stuff,
invasive
sure.
surgery available
surgery
in the world today.
I could build that.
He said he just doesn't feel like making videos most of the time. Oh, that's fine.
My house is on full goddamn quarantine.
That's understandable.
I'll probably be dead in a week anyway. Not from the virus, like a electrocution accident or something. It's actually giving me a lot of free time. And what better way to spend free time right now than to help the medical industry? Now, I can't do any chemistry or biology or like body stuff. Yuck. But I can do robotics. And let me tell you, those Da Vinci surgery robotics rat bastards are ripping hospitals off. Look at this. $2 million for one shitty robot. They can spend that on a couple hundred bandages or like one ambulance ride in the US. We can build a better surgery robot for a lot less. Come on. The biggest flaw in Da Vinci's design is that it relies on these clunky, slow robotic arms for movement. Say you're operating on a patient's foot. He starts screaming out in pain. You gotta get up to his face, smack him around a little bit, make him shut up. Good fucking luck with these robotic arms. They're slow as shit and they don't have any travel distance. Instead, we're gonna mount the surgical tools to a rail system that can move anywhere on the operating table. Hey, look, it's past Michael. You know it took him 5 whole days to 3D model and build one rail carriage? What a dipshit.
Hey man, shut the fuck up. This shit's hard.
Maybe you little bitch. I'm the narrator. I'm like God. You can't kill me. Here's what the final carriage looks like. You see, it uses wheel bearings to travel up and down the slots in this aluminum rod. But Michael, you're just gonna use your hand to make it move? No, you're stupid, and I hate you. For power, we're using a brushless DC motor and an O-drive to turn this into kind of like a brushless servo motor. Do I know what that means? Absolutely fucking not. I've never done this before. What I do know is someone told my voice cracked. What I do know is someone told me this would be fast and very accurate, and all you have to do to put it in is... I forgot to record all the sound effects, okay? Give me a fucking break. Lit. I got the motor very professionally hooked up to the driver board, which is hooked up to my computer, so we can see what this thing can do. Okay, so this is the, like, calibration sequence. It needs to do this before it actually runs. Oh, that's so fucking sick! I think it should be a little faster, though. Okay, the motor has default parameters, so you can just turn those up. Let's try it out now.
Wow, very precise for surgery.
That's good. That's fast. Give me 1 second. Okay, you just stand right there.
Whoa, that's pretty cool.
We just gotta put this together and it looks like this. I did the quirky little snap teleportation thing, right? That was 3 weeks ago. I'm fucking tired. But I built this test platform out of aluminum and wood that I stole from my girlfriend's bed frame. It's not like I can go to Home Depot on quarantine. It's just a prototype so I can write and test the software before I build the actual thing, but even the prototype is pretty cool. It's the same idea with the motor carriage on the x-axis, but now I have 2 additional motors on the y-axis. And on their own, they're just motors. They don't know how to talk to each other, they don't know how to cooperate. But if you write some software that can talk to all the motors, you can make it do pretty much anything you want. This is the homing sequence. It figures out the bounds of the machine by measuring the amperage of the motors when they stop. Yeah, you can make it do this shit. It's maybe not as stable as you'd want it to be, but yeah, it's just a prototype. So stupid.
Yeah, it's just our early
version.
I'm controlling
with my mouse right now. It looks jerky and awful, but it's actually got a really good amount of precision to it. It's kind of going in a circle from the top down view. Like I said, this is not the final surgery robot. It's going to be much more refined, much more medical looking, you know, much more safe for the user. And all that movement was controlled by the code I wrote. Don't worry, I'm not going to show it. I know everyone thinks it's boring, so we...
Psych, I don't give a shit what you think. Look at this dynamic bounds detection routine that's fucking sick.
Here's a limit switch. You can put it here to detect the bounds of your machine. Yeah, fuck that limit switch. It's crazy. Instead, write some code that steps the motor forward until it starts using a lot of power, then you know you hit the edge of the rail, and then you know exactly where you are in relation to the bounds of the machine. It's fucking sick! Look how cool the code part is, guys. I'm gonna keep going. This part applies the scaling factors that are calculated as a function of the input. But Michael, I hear you ask. So you can move the carriage over any part of the operating table you want. Great. But how are you going to move the medical tools up and down to engage with the patient? Well, that's where the carriage utility mechanism comes into play. That's the thing that's going to move the scalpel or the clamp or whatever up and down, which is great.
There's just potato,
a small
problem,
slight problem. Well, I built it, which is a good thing. My original plan was, you know, just to have a thin piece of plastic with a motor attached to it that moves a plate. Easy. But then I saw that thing. Okay, there's no way that's gonna survive, so I gotta make it a little strong. You know, I may as well make it go a little faster. I got a little carried away, and now it looks like a time bomb, and it weighs 10 fucking pounds. It works great. The motor precisely moves the mounting plate up and down wherever you want it to go. The thing is, I just don't know if those motors can handle 10 pounds, so we're gonna have to do a little test.
Michael, why don't you just use the carriage utility mechanism to test it out?
Well, it took me a long time to build, and it's fucking beautiful, so cry more. It looks like it's handling small movements pretty well. Y-axis action. Okay, that's not that bad. Okay, oh, it's fine. It'll be fine. We can probably. probably just go ahead and make the final version. And it
Blissful,
looks
thanks
like
for the prime.
I did the stupid hand thing again. It's been 3 more weeks. I have severe depression. But Michael, where's the surgery robot? Wait for it, wait for it. Oh, big reveal, this
Whoa.
Is the surgery robot. Massive payoff, huge, I have brain damage. Behold the superior surgery robot, you Da Vinci shittertins. It's got the comm, it's got the cable management. It's got the super fucking hard to reach driver boards. I don't know why I put them under here. I thought it would look cool. But Michael, does it even work? Does it work? Does it work? I don't know if it works. I haven't turned it on yet. I've been too afraid since it took me so long to build, so I turned the camera on so you can at least see my tears when it tears itself apart. I'm worried about this shit because when I built it, I went ooga booga caveman brain, metal strong. Metal not strong. Metal more like McDonald's play place trampoline. But you gotta take chances when you're innovating on the next great thing, so I'm gonna turn it on. Oh god, oh please. Yeah, okay. Please don't break it. Yeah! Alright, the machine's working. Now we can start to control it. But Michael, where's the controller? Fuck you. You are the controller. I got this
Whoa.
VR hand tracking camera off of Amazon that works super goddamn well. So you just take the hand coordinates from this, pipe them into the surgery robot, and bing bang boom. Oh, boom! Fuck you, Da Vinci Robotics. You can move my thing with just floating your hand around. Robot, go here. Ooh, robot, do surgery here. Oh, no, patient bleeding there. Oh, do surgery there on that part. How about you do surgery
At that point, why do you even
here.
Need
now
the robot?
Over there, and now do surgery. Fuck you, Da Vinci.
Oh my God.
Shitty robot can't do that. You need to squeeze those little metal robot teeth to do yours.
Yo, Jolly, thanks for 27
Before
months.
I sell my design to surgeons across the nation, we have to attach some surgical tools to the cum, because otherwise, it's just a big-ass robot. So let's buy a scalpel on Amazon. Wow, that is just unacceptable.
Oh, potato,
scalpels
thanks for the 10
gifted. Scalpels
are
going to take a
whole
3 days. Thank you. Pretty reasonable. Fuck no, that's messed up. Dang
Very
global
much.
Health crisis. That's far too long. If only I had an alternative. When you really think about it, scalpels are just shitty, smaller knives. So why don't we just use bigger, better knives? Like, hello, we already have those. Wake up, sheeple. Are you tired of outdated surgical technology? Are you looking
yeah.
for the cutting edge in power, precision, and usability?
Yeah.
Look no further. The future of surgical robotics is here.
Look at the fucking knife!
Unlike some other surgical systems, we've run a gamut of tests to ensure
I feel
our
like this
machine
isn't a surgery
power.
Machine anymore.
I'm gonna stab a pineapple with oh, fuck. Commencing the operation. Operate on it. Surgery over here now. Patient. Small incision, we'll move the patient. Commence surgery on the patient. But power isn't the only thing we strive for. Precision is an essential tenet of surgery, and we make no exceptions from testing for accuracy. What the fuck is that?
Hey, ready to do some painting? No, Lily, come on, please.
Oh shit, oh fuck! Draw the Mona Lisa. Draw the Mona Lisa.
Oh, is that the
painting?
The
painting?
Eyes?
That's a little racist looking, Lily. I'm not gonna. Yeah. Yeah.
I'm not gonna pressure you, but this is supposed to show how accurate my machine is.
It'll reach the water.
Let's see a Da Vinci try to do that. You might be wondering, is the system FDA approved?
Of course.
But don't just take our word for it. Here's what a real medical professional Goldie, has to say about this innovative
months.
New technology. We're gonna go for like a laparoscopic appendectomy. So if we just make a small incision above the chest here, we can, okay. A little bit more difficult for some procedures, but not, you can see you still have a lot more accurate control than a lot of surgical systems. Like I was saying, moving the patient is a lot easier with the system. Like normally you'd have to manually move them. Would you add this to your hospital? Do you think hospitals could adopt?
Seems a little dangerous.
Okay, I appreciate the feedback. You're wrong. Last but not least, we've made our machine so intuitive that anyone can do surgery with no prior training. So you've never seen this machine before in your life?
No.
This is perfect because this study is to see if we can bring someone from zero skill level all the way up to the ability of a surgeon. Boot up right in front of him. Not too close because it's kind of dangerous. So just put your hand out. Could you just put your hand out above the thing? Higher up controls the knife position. You can move it further.
That is fucking terrifying.
Further away from you. We're gonna make a small incision right above the ear.
There's Summer 6. Okay, so you're doing it wrong. Okay, so clearly. Well, fuck. Oh, cut. You're clearly doing another incision
guys,
to stop. Plug the hole with the knife.
Yeah, 10 months, perfect. Guys, knife. Big money, big money.
Oh, this. What's. It's okay. No, it's fine. It's learning. It's a learning experience. Try and retract the knife from the head. Let's just try and get it out of. Yeah.
It works perfectly. She's just okay, doing it wrong. Season. Yeah, clearly.
If your patient's you're over here and you don't want him to be over there, move him over here. Do some surgery over here. Move him back. I don't even know what surgery this was supposed to be. Thank you for watching. That
brain stabbing surgery
for my surgical system. If you're a hospital looking to try
Jesus.
It out, follow me on Twitter, subscribe to me on YouTube, and maybe, just maybe, I'll let you borrow it for a bit. Remember, stay
wow.
in school, smoke crack,
how
fuck
thoughtful.
You, Da Vinci robots, bye. This YouTube video is sponsored by Raycon. I have to send them this
hey,
ad early.
Raycon.
No fucking idea what's
people
going
used to
on.
Always get Raycon sponsors.
Wireless earbuds. They come in at about half the price of any other premium option. But it's not a sacrifice for quality. They sound
those things were expensive as hell.
I've said it before, but I've been using Raycon since before they even sponsored me. I just needed something wireless and affordable, and they ended up being really good quality too. I wore them the entire time I was assembling parts of the surgery robot, which is no problem for their new Everyday E25s because they got 6 hours of battery life, seamless Bluetooth pairing. They fit really well. At the end of the day, I just fucking care that they're good earbuds and I don't have
it's
to worry
a lot
about
of blood
them. They
on
just
it.
Fucking work. So if you're interested, click the link in the description to go to buyraycon.com.
Alright, I think it's unban request
again,
time.
This video really started to add
honestly, I was never gonna do unban requests ever again.
I appreciate it. And
but Allie said that she went through them and it's only like.
That's the end of the video.
She cleansed them, I guess, but there's still a lot to go through.
Dude. You can fall off!
I actually was watching Cutie a little bit earlier. Oh yeah, S-Fans video.
Oh my fucking god. That run was insane.
I feel like nothing happened though. Hold on. Inside the OTK Games Expo. Wow.
Yo, what's up guys? We are here at WePlay Studios. We're gonna walk through everything with Avalee. Avalee May has been setting up the whole show this year. We're gonna meet with her today. We're gonna see some of the other guys. So it's gonna be a big show. At the point in which you guys have seen this video, or are seeing this video, you guys have probably already seen the show. But maybe we'll get a chance to talk to them in the behind the scenes too. We'll see.
As soon as Emmy gets here, I'll run up. We'll have our quick little jam.
Little moth. Please, guys,
please eat. Make sure you're fueled up, and then we'll be good to go.
I love the art on this one.
You are.
I was not the only one late. Actually, I think I was, actually.
There's no
actually,
way.
I think I was. There's me.
I don't think I saw the trailer for this one.
I want you to count the under boob.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, hell yeah. This is horny. I love it.
Honestly, I didn't even know they were filming.
I'll be honest, that trailer was lame right. for what I
it was not that bad.
Yeah, like that trailer
it wasn't bad.
Because the one I saw was like the amount of boob jiggling was fucking ridiculous.
Can we get that trailer? I feel
and it
like
was awesome.
I can get it on my phone.
We're not playing this, but did you have fun doing your recording?
What recording? Oh, that's the game I'm in? I didn't know.
Yeah.
It was okay, I suck.
I'm trying to wait to hear it.
You're excited anyway.
That's me.
Is that you?
Oh yeah, when that one played, no one knew it was Soda's voice because it didn't sound like him at all.
Watch this! Who said Yippee?
I've never heard Yippee like that before.
Oh, Yippee! Like, they wanted me to voice it for like 80 different takes.
Tricks, thanks for
yippee.
2 months.
Like, how many different ways can I say this?
Good to go. Does anyone have any other questions?
I'm excited.
You did great.
Thank you.
This is amazing. See you, man.
It's gonna be really good. I'm gonna go work on the action show. That's okay, so. We're gonna go, we're gonna play test some of the games and stuff that we're gonna show on the actual Games Expo.
Yo, Ryan, thanks for the Prime.
With a Topo Chico.
Is this just all rehearsals?
Okay, let's go check out the stage. Early look at the Games Expo stage. They're putting everything together now. But yeah, let's look at this.
Some is the actual show, I guess.
No specialist, man. Yeah, we're right now we're trying to get like the online working. We're a full rollback game.
Oh my god, he's a game!
Off that.
Hope you guys enjoy, or enjoyed, whatever it is.
We're gonna get through this, or I will die.
Have fun.
Yeah, they did good. It's always nice being able to show up to something, do nothing, and then be like, yep, I did my job. It's very nice.
All I have to say is...
Is this the thing?
Shadow Legends.
Oh, Raid, yeah.
Thanks.
Thanks, Raid Shadow Legends.
Thank you, Raid Shadow Legends.
Fuck yeah, Raid Shadow Legends. How much are they...
The funny thing is, apparently Raid likes things like that. Like, they lean into the joke. I was like, oh, that's actually pretty cool. Pretty cool of them. Hold on. Ugh. I'm still alive, even if I've got the cold sweats. It's fine. Ugh. It's fine. Okay, time for unbanned requests.
Sup?
Oh god. Hello, what's up? Okay, so this guy was- he always typed a lot. He's got over 100 messages. Seemed pretty normal for the most part. Unmute the stream, get rid of the blur, no audio, hospital trip, hospital vlog, women fish and men want Austin. Why does your backpack have all these problems, but other IRL streams have no issue? Deleted by... Next time get the OTK equipment, dude. S-Ven, your tech sucks. Thought it was fair to point out the backpack issues. Sorry if it got under someone's skin. I mean... It is just annoying, because it's like, I mean, we know when it's effing, and S-Fan banned them. I don't know, what do you guys think? Keep banned or no? Unban? Yeah, I mean, it, like, it seemed like they were just, like, chilling normal always before that. It's just, like, a small thing. Okay. I wish Emiru was my girlfriend. Come on, it's Black History Month, man. What? Alright, kinda weird. Okay. Emiru and Emily, imagine. After you leave the waiter, is gonna- what? I can't even believe I said that. Wow. I don't know why I didn't reread it before sending. After hitting send, I was in disbelief. I actually meant to say lick the seat. Won't happen again, I swear. Bro, what? I thought it was a genuine apology at first. What the heck? This is a deny, right? Yeah, how is that any better? That's worse! Oh my god. I can't wait to see the bouncing. That comment has been caused by a momentary lapse of judgment. I was so excited when I saw DDR with Alinity in the title, and the part of my brain took over. I'm deeply sorry and regret bringing unwanted horniness into the chat. Please, if I get another chance being in Emmy's chat, I promise to never ever... Even if Alinity did hot tub wearing a small pink bikini on Emiru's stream, make another lewd comment again. Very specific. Yeah, that is very specific. I'll think this is a keep or a kick. Deny or unban. I mean, it's not that bad, I guess. Emiru, marry me. Emiru, adopt me, please. I don't want to marry you anymore. Please unban me. Don't happen again, please. Wow. What the heck? Unbanned, but he never even contributed anything besides two weird things. Like, if he were, like, a normal guy, then sure, you lost him. He doesn't want to marry me anymore. Banned. This is so sad. Yeah, he's not even a chatter. So, oh, I banned this person. Sekiro, hella boring, worst Souls game, Sekiro. Triggered. Sometimes people have opinions that differ from your own. Bloodborne or Elden, way better choice. This game's a hard pass. Okay, but I banned this because I was like, you're just being annoying. Like, just close the stream if you don't want to watch it. It's not that hard. Like, huh? I was being a negative little bitch. Sorry, I've been having a bad year. No excuse, though. I will be a positive, happy person from now on. I promise. I will buy a sub day. And gift a sub because I love Emmy streams. Thumbs up. Please consider unbanned for I'll change my ways and become a better person. I can't tell if he's just being extremely sarcastic or what. I mean, probably. Yeah, I'll unban it. That's fine. It wasn't even a big deal. Okay. Most annoying voice I've heard in years. Yo, Potato, thanks for the 20 gifted. Villain's voice makes me want to dead face emoji gun. Jesus, okay. Yo, was wondering if I could get unbanned. I'm sorry for what I said and won't do it again. I just got annoyed because the stream was chill, and then that other girl came out of nowhere being loud, but I shouldn't have said those things. I've never done something like that before here or any of the Twitch chat. Don't know why I thought it'd be a good idea, but I'm sorry for what I said. And hope I could get unbanned and participate in the stream within the guidelines and stream rules. Smile. I mean, I just don't like when people are rude to other people on the stream. Because it's like, it's one thing to like, talk shit to the streamer. But it's like, I don't know. I don't like it. Twice in legal minute, donating to terrorist. What? I mean, I don't need to read the mod comments on all of them, just the ones that need context. I apologize for what I said. I was being edgy, irresponsible, and rude. I do not believe or support or believe anything seriously I said. I was fishing for reactions. I went back and looked at the VOD, and I have no clue who they're even calling a terrorist. I was being edgy. I'll no longer bring negativity and malice to Emmy's chat again if you deem me worthy of an unban. I'm sorry. I mean, it's weird. He seemed normal before that. Donating to terrorist. I feel like there's just, like, no context. I don't even, like, know if I should ban him or not. Maybe I'll give him another chance. Oh god. Wait, was Hassan here on this day? I don't think Hassan was there in October. Furry equals unbanned? Wait, where's it? I might be a furry now! Oh god. Yeah, I might have to not play games today.
Yo.
We'll see. Free him. I mean, I feel like this is like short. You can have a second chance, and then if he does it again, he'll just get banned again. ADC diff. Diamond ADC Lamao boosted. Most garbage Ash I've ever seen. Boosted monkey. You should probably go back to paying for ELO boosting, just absolute trash. 0-3 diamond player, be more obvious. My bad, I'm reformed. True, diamond players never go 0-3. 4 years ago, Jesus Christ! I mean, if he says he's reformed, it must be true, right? So, I mean, 4 years ago is like, whatever. Stupid bitch. I was under the influence. Please, or forgive me for calling you a stupid bitch, you stupid bitch. Why is he typing numbers? Free him? But bro, he never even contributed anything anyway. He just types numbers. And stupid bitch. Get out of here. Jesus Christ, this is level 42. I would kill Miz with my bare hands on his sleep if I was her. Report Miz Kiff for the USA government. I don't know why I'm banned. Is it because Miz Kiff got mad because of this? Unban me, please. I just want to read chat. I won't type anything anymore. What? Like, bro, it's not that serious. For the government? Oh my god. Yeah, must have been Miz that banned it, not just because of the random borderline death threat. Nah, keep him in there? Yeah, maybe. It's been 5 years, I guess, and I don't even know what my dumbass did. He was banned 2019. I don't know what you did either, so. Yo mods, down with the, I don't like furries in my opinion, they're kind of weird. I don't like how they're forcing kids to be trans. Why is Christianity hated? What? IDC. What? What is this?
Then what the fuck is stopping us from just throwing ourselves off a bridge and giving up and saying, yeah, the planet is dying, the government hates us, the animals are leaving, the aliens aren't contacting us, we might be alone, it just might be you and me, but that's okay, because do you really need anyone else?
I can't believe it was only 3 years ago. Only 3 years? Why is it so good? Well, he says he doesn't care, so I guess I don't either. Good for him, I guess. Wow. I want to punch Miz Kiff in a video game. And then he banned him. Really? Come on now. He did say in a video game. I mean, he is also a Miz sub. And a Seer sub, so he probably doesn't actually hate him. Wait, he was timed out before. Oh. Yeah, I feel like he probably didn't mean it that way and got caught at a bad time. Because I think this was during WoW, to be fair. So he probably thought it was like an admin angry viewer or something. My bad. This was in response to someone saying, should I just end it all? Well, yeah, I mean, for all I know, they were just joking, but, I mean, that's kind of bad, so. So cringe, yet she freaks out when some black guys pull up, so cringe. My bad. This was in reference to a clip from Emily when she got harassed by two guys in public and was freaked out by it. Yeah. That's, I don't know. Not in this dungeon, lol. 10k points on Godskin Duo. My rage quit. Dragon must have been Hispanic in a past life the way he's hitting that woman. Bro, what? That's crazy. Is this that one lady? What's the name of Pretty Girls? What's everyone's favorite country in Africa? What's everyone's favorite African country? Why did he ask that question 2 weeks apart? Twice. I strongly dislike Kevin Hart. Please. What? I mean, it's not like Kevin Hart's coming on my stream, you know? He can say his opinion, I guess. That's fine. Cringe. What? Question mark? Was part of the wave of Hassan haters that came in when he showed up for cosplay. I mean, maybe he was calling me cringe, I don't know. There's not enough evidence to... Not enough evidence. Chinese spy. Sorry. Wait, like, they were calling me a Chinese spy? I mean, they said sorry. Wait, is anyone else a Chinese spy here? First time chatter as well. That's crazy. I mean, it's not even that bad, right? He didn't say anything, like, racist, but... Nah. Yeah, it's like too ridiculous to be offensive. It was the New Year's stream? Oh. Oh, then it is kind of weird. The Chinese New Year's stream? No. Why do you support China? Hey there. I didn't want to start a political discussion or anything. I was just wondering. I'm never going to talk about anything related to this ever again. Please unban me, please. Big eyes emote. Why do they think I support China? Is it because I said I was Chinese or something? Like, shit, I'm sorry. The people who get banned for first time messages, I'm just always like, why would I let them back? Emiru comes off as so dumb. She's just repeating what other people are saying and not really contributing with anything at all. Why am I wasting my time here? Opinion's not allowed, okay? True. She's right. What was I even doing? Was I just reacting or something? Opinions not allowed. I mean, to be fair, this guy probably has a lot of other really great opinions. Probably. Oh wait, this was when I was playing Elden Ring and shit. But you're still cringe. Ew, Tectone, ew, shut the fuck up, Tectone. Fuck Tectone, thank God, ew, Tectone, ew. Ew, Tectone, shut up, Tectone, ew. Wait, but he posts the exact same things every time that Tectone is there. Ew, Tectone, ew, I don't care. Ew, Tectone, send to Asmin. Ew, Dota, no, fuck him, whale in Honkai, call IRS. Ew, Tectone, but you still... Dang, this is like a dedicated Tectone hater, to be fair. Mod him. Well, that's like all that he says. I mean, but he likes Honkai, so why does he hate Tectone? I mean, he's not even sorry though, and I don't want, even if it's Tectone, I don't want people coming in chat and spamming. The gacha, wait, actually that's true, a lot of gacha people don't like Tectone. He's probably a Tectone viewer, though, to be fair. I I know a lot of people are on this bandwagon, but Tektone's my friend, so. Girls marry me. Unban me because this was about bullcrap. What? Okay. Tektone, who is the skeleton? I'm not entirely sure why I was banned. There was someone on stream wearing a skeleton outfit, and I just asked who it was. When have I ever had someone in a skeleton outfit on stream? This was a gym stream. No one was wearing a skeleton outfit. Oh. I was like, when have I had someone wearing a skeleton outfit on stream? Okay. He lied in his unban request. Get out of here. Please show Fabobas and TDs. It was my dog. Mm. Yeah. Hey, Emiru, I love you, baby. I don't understand my ban. I just like following Emiru. Sorry for anything. I'll be more respectful in my messages. Yeah, like, I feel whenever I see someone in chat that's like, they're like hitting on me, I'm like, I just feel like it's making the vibes weird for everyone else. That's why I told my mods to just ban it. Like, any like pet names or anything. Oh mine, are you a real extremely beautiful person? I don't know why I was banned, no offense intended. If this is something wrong, then keep me banned. I mean, this one's not as bad. That profile po. The profile picture. Check DMs for the EU Tektone guy. You are the best husband. Beating woman. You are a true OTK. Okay, so he is a Tektone viewer, but he's like a Tektone schizo, I guess. Nice. I mean, this is fine. He didn't say anything like lewd or like say a pet name or anything, I guess. And I mean, if he's weird, he'll just get banned again. Careful not to let Alinity touch your cats. I didn't think it was offensive since it was true. Milo. I mean, I don't think Alinity cares about comments like this, because she makes jokes about it all the time. As long as they're not, like, hating on her, I don't think she cares.
Yo.
Exclamation point, guys kissing. Ban me, I'm horny. Okay. Look, I don't understand my own sexuality right now, I'm sorry. What? I think he needs some time to figure himself out, you know. Worcestershire, 420 gang. Kai is probably the worst streamer, but Speed also exists, so I don't know. Pasties. Never realized how big they were. Okay, those last two messages sound creepy out of context, but I swear I wasn't talking about her boobs. What else would you be talking about, though? I don't know. Why is your voice cracking so much? Not offensive. Bro, what's in your head? Bro, what's back on your head? Anorexia hits. I was rude and all. All I want is being able to see people react. Please unban. I won't write bad things anymore. What does this even mean, though? Anorexia hits. What does that mean? Answer his question, not offensive. Because I'm going through puberty, I guess. Might have been during a gym stream. I don't know. Yay, second puberty. Why was I banned? I can't remember. Banned 2019. Yeah, when they've got nothing, I just ban them. Man, she got nice rack. I was talking about the training rack. I am sorry. Yeah. I don't know about that one, bruh. Tectone always ruining streams. Like, fuck off. Don't like Tectone. Shrug emoji. Oh my god, the day Tectone died. Jesus. Okay, at first Wait, this is another guy who just types about Tectone all the time. Streamers are fucking disgusting, including you. Yeah, true. Asmin Frog's mad. Playing Tectone is an easy way to want to fur? I feel like he meant to say die. True, fuck Asmin's chatters. Tectone must be the cringiest. Jesus. Yeah, that's pretty bad. Okay. Ms. Kiff stopped rating you. No, I don't think so. Is this a hashtag ad for Sushi Dragon? This is interesting for like 5 minutes. Snapchat filters. He was under 1K. Think he needs it. I apologize for not respecting Sushi Dragon enough. In the future, I won't comment. Parentheses, be passive aggressive. If others, parentheses, not Emmy, tell viewers to leave Emmy's stream to watch theirs. Thanks for considering my unban. Wait, what happened? This was when Dan Clancy was with Sushi Dragon at Ironforge, and they asked you to try out the AI face morph thing. Weirdos in chat started complaining that they were leeching. Someone got timed out, some got banned. This guy was just unlucky. Yeah, they weren't really- this person wasn't calling him a leech. I guess he just got caught in the crossfire. I guess. Yeah. That's fine. Implied cause of- I mean, the view count thing is kind of cringe. I don't know, what do you guys think? He didn't even tell other people to leave my stream and watch theirs, did he? I mean, if he did, he was joking, I think. I'll give him another chance, and then if- I mean, we'll just get banned again. If it's bad, I guess. Spank Bank, Dan's game, why is he so loud, annoying? Hilarious, annoying social abilities. Kids walking around, he's being a complete idiot, why the fuck is he so loud? At floor, suck a D. Context, Tectone was being Tectone, and my response was to the vitriol directed me for being shocked by his nonsensical yelling and cursing while children were present in an arcade setting. I mean, not only a Tectone hater, he was fighting people in chat. Does he think Tectone reads Emmy's chat? I mean, he does. He gets fucking spam pinged. I mean, the only bad, super bad part, I think, is this part. I feel like this one could be a second chance, perhaps. Giga Chad, bro, this is Roman Legionnaire workout pog. I would sniff so hard. Sorry, it was a bad joke about sniffing Canute, but I didn't mean it that way. I don't think I wrote something offensive ever except the sniff part. Is it any better if it's Canute? I mean, they were a normal chatter before that. They were probably just joking, right? I mean, they probably wouldn't actually want to sniff Canute's butt, right? Right? I don't think he'd care. I love you, Emiru. Unban me, please. What the fuck? And this guy's just weird. Can this guy get out of the room? Jesus Christ. I was unjustly banned by a possibly corrupt moderator on the payroll of a despotic tyrant by the name of Ms. Kiff, whose stream I've never watched and never will. I can in good name apologize for what I said. I meant every word of it. If you were to so kindly unban me, I would probably say thank you. How are these people real? What? Is this real or is this a joke? What? Yeah, okay. Emiru, ugly bitch. Emiru, ugly bitch. Emiru, ugly bitch. I'm very sorry for calling Emiru ugly. I was only joking. I'm sorry, I'll be very friendly in chat from now on. I'm sorry. What is this face? Is that like a tongue? Like, colon 9. I mean, he is very funny. I was only joking. What is this supposed to be? Oh, he was probably trying to do a sad face and he fucked it up. Damn, he couldn't even emote correctly in his apology. Ame pilled. Is this like a fucking weeb? Yeah, his first time chatter. Leave gnome clown. I was just commenting on the game. Why? It's not about someone real. This was the cosplay stream with Arya and Hunan when every incel in chat got butthurt that Miz was walking around his own house. Gnome clown, Jesus Christ. On the game, yeah. If it was with Arya and Hunan, I didn't even play a game that day, I don't think. Why do they lie, though? I guess they don't know that you can, like, check, I guess. Begging on my knees, please become my GF. I wasn't aware of the rules. I apologize. What rules? That's just weird. What? Okay. Fat fucking bitch, play the game. Never again. What? He got timed out before. What flavor of Asian are you? What? What? What does that mean? Yeah, this person's crazy. What the fuck was that? Oh, Jesus. They really like emotes. I'll be nice. Is this not a bot? Bro, his profile picture's terrifying. I mean, what is even the point of this? I mean, he'll be nice, but, don't need that. Wait, I banned this person in 2018! Wait, how come most of the people who got banned in 2019 have no logs, but this person does? 2018, go to the kitchen. I banned them myself, dot. I have, in fact, been in the kitchen. I mean, it was 6 years ago, whatever. Dude, Hassan is cringe AF. Can Pokimane shut the fuck up? Okay. Alright. Yo, Potato, thanks for another gift sub. What the fuck is this? Hey chat, can we take a moment to what? Hashtag Emiru lover, hashtag can't believe it's not butter. Huge apology for my recent spamming. Looking back, it was cringe, desperate, and creepy. I was caught up in the moment and thought it was funny. I promise it won't happen again. Ever. Believe me, that's not the kind of viewer and person I want to be. Please consider my unbanned kind soul. I mean, as long as they don't do it again, I guess. Damn, that baby is ugly. What baby? I really am sorry. It was out of line. I don't know why I said that. I won't disrespect anyone like that again. What baby? Pretty sure this was Tyler, one of Michaela's baby. Oh my god. That's fucked.
Rate a tartar.
Oh no. Leave the baby out of this. I mean, what do you guys think? I mean, yeah, a lot of babies are kind of weird looking. I mean, as long as he doesn't say anything like that again. Watch out, there's a black guy behind y'all. Jesus. Hello, I'm sorry. This was the bodyguard at the mall with Pokey. Yeah, that's very funny, bruh. Pokimane, scammer, and poop and pants. She scammer. Yep. She scammer. Walmart Pokimane. I didn't know she played Counter-Strike. I'm sorry, I won't be mean anymore. I won't even type anything in chat. What? What does that have to do with anything? I just want to be able to say what people are saying. I know I banned, but honestly, kind of based. How am I similar to Pokey at all? Oh, maybe he wanted to be unbanned when I played in the Counter-Strike tournament because he wants to read the amazing Counter-Strike chat. Girl equals similar? Actually true. Well, I mean, I guess maybe I'll see how he is if I ever play CSGO again. You know, Emiru, yesterday I was thinking about falling into an abyss. Can I see Ezfan, please? I just became American yesterday. What a song. Emiru, you're so beautiful. Will you go on a date with me? And I really mean it. Spaghetti is your safe word. Will you marry me? What? I'm really sorry, not normally like that. Yo, Draco, thanks for the 5 gifted. Okay. Hi, Emily. Accidentally ended up here, but hi. Have a good stream, B. Your hair's grown so much, like my Johnson. Okay. Oh god, I'm sorry, my throat's really bad. I'm sorry if that sounded weird. What I meant was your hair has grown so much over the years. In the same way, my son named Johnson is also my Johnson. Okay. It was his son Johnson, yeah. My sister's 30, 30s into 20. Tectone is 50 at least. I mean, I feel like he's just a normal, he's just joking. It was just a bad joke. I don't know, what do y'all think? Actually, nah. Oh, what the fuck is this?
Merp.
I don't even want to read this. Emiru Senpai, my heart does the kawaii anime sweat every time you glance at the webcam. You're like the ultimate gamer waifu material. Your laugh makes butterflies erupt in my stomach that are more powerful than a level 100 Charizard. I would spend all my Twitch bits and just to hear you say my name, even if it's just a donation notification. Please notice me, Senpai. Uwu, your eternal simp knight. I won't type anymore, sad face. Like, when I see stuff like this, I'm like, this can't be real, right? But then, like, how are people like this real? Goodbye. If you unban me, I will sign Eminem Rap God on 2x speed in a Discord call. On Skibbity. I mean, that's impressive, but I just really have no interest in that. Can I buy one of your socks? Just asking. Can I get a... Oh. Alright then. Alright, I guess I just won't read what he said. Yeah, maybe it was a Nick account. Double scissors. Unban me, please. Sorry for my mistake. Couldn't this just be about when... all the times I lost the scissors and I had multiple pairs? Doubles. I'm not sure though. Yeah, or like rock, paper, scissors? No, this wasn't fan, this was in March. What would this be about? Okay. What is this? Boom. Can I please be unbanned? This is just cruel. An XQC chatter in the wild, an ironic but racist 9/11 joke. What is this Oh, wait, is that a guy where- Oh. I couldn't tell what that emoji was. Oh, yikes. It looked like a glass of milk or something. Yeah, that's, his name is also XXX69 Booty Sniffer 420 XXX. Yeah, Fortney in League is the most funny. Women on League. Congrats, after 10 years of playing the game, you won versus new players. You are not Tyler. You pressed him. No offense, but women can't play in offense. I'm sorry, my comment was rude. What? What? Let him out, cat wants to pee. She is young and she doesn't understand cat wants to pee. What? It seems like this guy only types for League. Women on League. Tyler won, yeah, the League brain rot. What a strange individual. Should I unban him? So we can have some toxic people in chat when I eventually play League. True, everyone here is toxic enough. Hi, Prawn Girls. Emiru, if you're going to host porn actresses on your stream, don't ban people for calling it out. Mods, stay mad and keep me banned.
Most what? Sane Twitch unban requests Kappa.
Yeah, we have some great chatters. And this is the filtered version. Huh? Just like a weird thing to say though. There should be an incel badge, that would be sick. Hi Emiru, hi Emiru, hi Emiru, hi Emiru, hi Emiru. Emiru, notice me. Hi Emmy, Emmy say hi to me. Unban won't happen. I mean, this isn't that bad, he's just annoying. Like, if y'all saw this guy spamming, would you think it was annoying, or would you just not even notice? Wouldn't care. I mean, we'll see if he learns from it, I guess, then.
Hey, Emmy, how are you?
I know. I'm sick, but besides that, I'm fine. He asked you to wait 40 hours before reposting. This won't be reposted as a VOD. He only asked for 40 hours before farming the content. Why are you defending this? It's sad. I misunderstood what Internet Historian was asking for with the 40-hour repost react time limit. I thought it applied to Twitch as well. Then I decided to argue my wrong position with a mod. That was super dumb. I regret it. Not only was I wrong, it turns out I was trying to defend a plagiarizing piece of shit. I sincerely regret everything and I'm sorry. I mean, he just misunderstood. He wasn't, like, really being rude or anything, so. I feel like it's fine, right? It's just a misunderstanding, I guess. Guilty of being stupid. Yeah, we'll unban him. And that's it, except for the new ones, but I don't know if the new ones are gonna be weird or not. That was short, it was only like 90 or something. Bro acting like Internet Historian killed his mother. I love Internet Historian. I think his videos are great. So Wuthering Waves, right? I'm debating if I just go lay down. Oh god. I mean, I'm streaming Saturday as well. Yeah, I might just go rest and take a COVID test as well, because I'm a little bit concerned. I hope it's not. I don't think it is, but I feel like I should take one. Ugh. Yeah, I'll do a longer stream on a... Oh, wait. My god, Emily is just as autistic as her brother. Wait, what? I was talking about Emily being like her brother, Miz, because she put out a candle with onion and proceeded to take a bite out of it. What? Emiru, how about every time you cry, you get tased? What? Interesting. Alright. Yeah, I think I'm gonna end early and go rest, because I'm actually, like, sweating like crazy. It's not good. Yippee. I'm so happy that I got sick from a party I didn't even go to. Yippee. Alright, who's live? Yeah, sorry it was only 2 hours today, but I just wanted to at least go live, even if for a short amount of time. Yeah, this is what happens when I leave the house. I'm gonna raid Will, I guess. But yeah, sorry, only 2 hours. I was just like, I feel like I'm gonna regret it if I don't stream at all today. Since if I go live on Saturday, it would have been a whole week. But I made it through 2 hours. Now I'm gonna go, probably take a bath and then sleep. But yeah, I'll be back on Saturday, and then I think that, Tuesday, Bao's coming over to hang out with me. Bao the whale, the VTuber. I don't know exactly what we're gonna do yet, but she asked if I wanted to stream together. So that'll be fun. She's really fucking funny and cool. You guys will like her if you don't already watch her. So yeah, I've got some stuff coming up. And I'm gonna go rest so that I am not sick, hopefully, by the time she's here, so I don't have to cancel. But yeah. Good night, everyone, at 6:30. I'll be back on Saturday, even if I'm still sick. So, yeah, goodbye.